This video is strictly for educational purposes only. I do not condone or glorify the usage of drugs.
Yo, what is up? In this video, I'm gonna explain everything you need to know about the differences between CBD, CBG, CBN, and CBC. These are all legal non-psychoactive derivatives of cannabis and provide mild calming effects. So if you don't like the feeling of being high or you get too paranoid or too anxious, these cannabinoids are worth looking into. And even if you do enjoy normal THC, these cannabinoids are still great to smoke in other situations on their own. Plus, you can mix them with your normal weed and have a session with different smoke combos too. I'll explain the differences between each cannabinoid and talk about the benefits, side effects, and why each one is unique in their own way. If you end up being interested in any of these herbs, I'll drop my link in the description for the best place that you can get them. Let's get into it. CBD versus CBG versus CBN versus CBC. Which one is better? The first one we'll cover is cannabidiol, or CBG. Typically, it is found in small percentages in the marijuana flower, but due to genetic breakthroughs in the hemp industry, it can now be grown as CBG dominant flower. Users report CBG being invigorating, focusing, promoting a clear state of mind, and being non-intoxicating. CBG is believed to obstruct GABA uptake in the brain and block serotonin receptors. This may be helpful for the treatment of anxiety and depression. Originally discovered in 1964, it provides many health benefits to its users. Its antibacterial properties make it help fight against bacterial infections. It can relieve neuropathic or inflammatory pain and act as a muscle relaxant. It has potential digestive benefits as a remedy for colitis and inflammatory bowel disease. And it has shown effectiveness in treating glaucoma, Huntington's disease, and MRSA. CBG can even be used as an anti-cancer agent. It has the potential to block the receptors that are responsible for the growth of cancer cells. Moving on to cannabinol, or CBN, this is a degradation product of Delta-9 THC with minimal intoxication and is reported to be great at providing calming sensations and nighttime relief. Originally discovered in 1930, it has many benefits with uses as a sleeping aid, immunosuppressant, stimulation of new bone growth, and pain reliever. It's also used as an appetite stimulant, which is good for people who like to get the munchies without getting high off the psychoactive effects from normal THC.
Munchies! Who wants some munchies?
Additionally, it acts as a neuroprotective agent and delays the onset of ALS, or Lou Gehrig's disease. CBN is one of the top sedative cannabinoids that make you tired. Because of this, there's a bong called the Smart Rig, which burns at a specific temperature to filter out all the CBN when you smoke normal weed. This allows you to still smoke all the other cannabinoids in the plant without getting tired or lethargic afterwards.
I am sick and tired. Being sick and tired.
Cannabichromene, or CBC, is probably the least known derivative on this list. First discovered in 1966, it tends to potentiate the effects of other cannabinoids when paired together. Specifically, some individuals who previously reported no effects from CBN report full effects when CBN is paired with other minor amounts of CBC. Typically, sativa strains of cannabis are most likely to feature high concentrations of CBC. In most strains of cannabis, it is the third most abundant cannabinoid besides THC and CBD. It is good for neurological health and reduces your likelihood of developing Alzheimer's disease or other neurodegenerative conditions. Plus, it's highly useful for aiding nerve and inflammation pain or pain caused by arthritis. Sometimes it's even used to treat acne or skin problems. CBC said that it would be helpful for pathophysiological conditions such as intestinal secretion, mucosal inflammation, visceral pain, and intestinal cancer. Lastly, we have cannabidiol, or CBD. The use of CBD has become widespread over the last few years. You could say that it was the first popular cannabinoid to arise since the original THC, hence why CBD is the most researched and more readily available out of all the other cannabinoids on this list. Originally discovered in 1940, it is the most abundant cannabinoid in the cannabis plant next to THC. There are many benefits to be had with CBD. It can be used to aid daily aches and pains, chronic pain, anxiety and panic disorders, nausea and vomiting, skin conditions, seizures, and inflammatory problems, to say the least.
Wow, that's a lot.
It is also one of the cheapest cannabinoids that are available, which is why it's great to mix with your normal THC if you like to conserve your weed or you just like looking for excuses to smoke more than you already do. Cannabis plant has over 100 different cannabinoids that are present in it, but that doesn't make it the only plant besides tobacco that you can smoke. There are actually thousands of different plants and herbs that you can smoke and get effects from. If you want to learn about some of those other smokeable herbs, here's a video I made showcasing a bunch of different legal plants that you can smoke. I'm Lowkey Fish. Peace out.